Now we will go one by one, basic in each protocol. So here is one protocol is LIN protocol, which means local internal connection network. Now local means what? It will be locally. Now in ECU there are networks which is locally to only one ECU, between two ECUs, and between more ECUs. So local networks are where these are the end of the network connection. So in a car there are so many networks. At the last node, that is a local interconnection network. That level they will implement LIN. So you can see some example in next slide where LIN is actually useful. So with that example, you can understand what is meant by local. And you can see this has developed by Freescale, Volvo, BMW, Audi, Volkswagen, and Daimler Chrysler. So these companies came together and decided to develop one protocol. Now LIN came after the CAN. So if you see a slide here, you can see LIN came in 2000 and CAN came in 1985. So there should be a question, why there is a need to have a LIN protocol? So you can see the first objective, LIN is low cost than CAN. It is a low, it's the cheapest protocol in automotive industry where you can implement it and you can do it. And it is a single master protocol. LIN protocol is single master where we don't share any clock, or master will control the communication between master and slave. So as soon as there's a master, there's a slave also. So one master issue, many slave issues. So this is a LIN protocol. And here you can see low cost, modest performance and safety requirements, flexible system architecture. So these are the some advantage of it. The main advantage of LIN is always cost. So you will understand that in the future when you work in automotive industry, how the cost will be reduced. Now here is the one message frame. Now you can will be a little bit confused what is mean by message frame. If you guys know UART or something, you may be more familiar with that. But if you don't know that also, think this as a sentence. So within a sentence, we will have a noun, we might have adjective, we'll have a verb. So that once combining of that, it is like one sentence. And at the end, you will have a full stop. In between, you can have comma to make it a sentence understandable. So within a sentence, what are these blocks are there? Similar, we have blocks in the a LIN frame. So consider this as a one sentence, and within that we have these blocks to understand or to give different information about that sentence. And here in overall perspective, you can see header, response space, response, and interframe space. Header is just a part where you have an ID. So it's like a noun for you. So we know the noun, it's a header. It's a main exam, main information about it. Then you have response space. So response, as I told you, the communication will be controlled by master. So either master will give the response, here he can pack the data, or the slave can give the response. Unless until a master asks a question either in your class, your teacher, you can't reply it. Because we are the slaves, we cannot give response. If you give response in between, it's like a communication failure, then you'll get punishment for it. So it's always a teacher will control the communication. So here, a master will control the communication. If he sends a header, after that, he will decide he wants to send a response or data, or you should, as a student, you should respond. So depend on the header, the data will be there. So this is a LIN message frame, and you can see the chunk of it, what is sync, ID, data, and checksum. Checksum is more or less to check the integrity, data integrity. If the data is communicated is good or bad, Good means it is not corrupted. Bad means it is corrupted. So this is a lean frame. Going further, you can see lean target application. As I told you, lean is local. Local means what? It is at the end of the network. So in our scenario, what is a local? In normal general, think local shops will be like whatever shops near to you. So which are the local shops, which are the like global shops, like malls, which will be for the many clusters of the towns, they will make one shop. So local will be like local to your area. So similarly, you can see lean target application, which is very local and do the specific task. So door, window, seat, ECUs will be implemented using a lean protocol, climate, seat, steering wheel, roof. So these are the application where lean protocol will be used to support these issues while communication. Next is CAN protocol. So CAN stands for Controller Area Network. And as I told you, this is the very first protocol implemented in automotive industry by the Bosch company. And here you can see the advantage of CAN is multi-master and event-based. Event-based, as I told you, it will be sometimes will be time-triggered or will be event-based. So whenever the event occurs, then only you will send the data. Future of CAN is CAN FD. So CAN FD, FD means flexible data rate. So as I told you previously, speed. Speed means how much data you will send within a specific time. So here data rate is that. Data rate means how much data you send within a 1 second. So CAN sends 500 kbps to 1 mbps data. And lean protocol will send 125 kbps data. So that's what speed difference is here. You can see that's why CAN is high speed protocol and lean is low speed protocol. And that's where cost will be a slow high. Everything will be complex here. And here is a CAN frame. As I told you, just think it as a sentence. Within sentence, these are the blocks. So you can see start of the frame. To understand a sentence is started, or to this frame is started, this block of data is started. Arbitration is a CAN concepts where the priority is defined between the CAN messages. Now CAN messages uses arbitration means to identify high priority message and to identify low priority message. So consider within consider if you are in some queue, and within that queue, if they have high priority for the older people, low priority for the younger people, then that will be identified with their age. So here in CAN, they will identify with the CAN ID. So if CAN ID is low, that means it's a high priority, and he will win the arbitration process. Next is control information. Here, a CAN frame will be control means the length of the CAN data, length, how much length data you're going to send. So this control information will be present here. EOF means end of the frame. End of the frame is our normal sentence will be full stop. So when we talk and if we take a break, that is also kind of end of frame. But in writing also, when you write a sentence and put a full stop, that means my sentence is complete. So similar way, if I'm sending some message, I need to tell another issue, this message ended here. To tell that, there's an end of frame where we pack some specific data depending on the rule, and he will understand, okay, this is the end of the frame. Acknowledge. So another issue should acknowledge whatever data he gets it. He should tell, okay, I got the data, it's fine. And CRC. CRC here you can see is a cyclic redundancy check. This means what? It's a checksum. It's a kind of checksum. It's just a different way. And here is one strategy I missed. CSMA CR. As I told you, carrier sense multiple access CSMA. CR means collision detection. So collision detection is like if two messages is collide with each other, or communication is in such some kind of data collision is occurs or not. To avoid that collision, they are using this methodology where they can detect if some collision is there. So these are the basic of CAN. Then we can go check FlexRay protocol. And you, if you have noticed it in that diagram, I have showed before the FlexRay there was a byte flight. So byte flight was a predecessor of the FlexRay protocol, and the FlexRay is a very high speed protocol than CAN. So it's developed for the safety related application, developed to support X by wire. X by wire, nothing but it's by wire. So we most of the times automotive protocols used to wire. So it can be a coaxial cable like you use in UART. So that is there for the communication. It has both time triggered and event triggered. Now you saw some advantage of time triggered. You saw some advantage of event triggered. You saw disadvantage of them also. So to avoid the those both, to get both advantage and to avoid those disadvantage, they are using both strategy here. Support of redundant transmission channel. So they can reduce a transmission channel if it's a duplicate. Data rate of 100 Mbps. So you saw the speed of, I just showed you the speed of CAN, which was 1 Mbps max, but here you can see it's a 10 Mbps. So it's a 10 times faster than CAN. Support of optical and electrical physical layers. So optical fiber, if you are from electronics background, you can know optical fiber is very high speed fiber where you can send the data with maybe 1 Gbps or 500 Mbps. It's possible. It's a costly, but it's possible. Then we have next, this is a FlexRay frame, and you can see it's very complex here. It just many blocks are there. So because we have now more features into it, we have time triggered also, we have event triggered also, so we need to take care of all those blocks. See here you can see main frame ID, payload length. Payload, nothing but data. How much data is there, that much called payload. It's just another name for it. Header CRC. So CRC is calculated of the any data. It just checksum of the data. Then cycle count. Cycle count is just how many count you times you will send that data, and again CRC of each data. So this is more or less a FlexRay frame. Then going further, we have FlexRay some information about topology. Can use double channel, means like two channels. Node, nothing but ECU. So at this end, one ECU will be connected. This end, another ECU. This end, another ECU. Depending on network, depending on the which ECU need what data from which ECU. So that's what we connect the ECU with each other. They can be connected using bus or single bus also is fine. This is one bus or star. This is star topology or mixed. Like mix like this. So depending on the requirements, depending on the data to be transmitted to another ECU, this network topology will be decided. Media will be tested pair cable or fiber, and you know the speed. This is just the example of how the one frame will be sent. These are the frames and how their time trigger and event trigger will be managed. So static segment and dynamic segment. Dynamic, static means will be fixed. Dynamic means it can be changed. Okay, so these are the slots here. Next is FlexRay ECU networks. Is just one diagram to understand you how ECU will be connected with each others. So these are the ECU and these are the connection between them. It just depending on the data, depending on the priority, they will be connected with each other. Next is the MOST protocol. So MOST stands for Media Oriented System Transport. As its name suggests, it supports the media. So media can be DVDs, car navigation radios, mobiles in our car. So most of the times, most will be used in instrumentation cluster. So if you see high-end cars like BMW, Audi, they'll be have so many features in their car instrumentation panel. Like you can do e-call, emergency call, you can have car navigation, you can have many things integrated in that panel. So founders of most is BMW, Audi, Daimler, SMSC, Harman Automotive. So these companies came together and they decided, okay, we need to support DVDs in the car, we need to support USB panel in the car, or we need to support something, videos, or something on the instrumentation panel. So that's why they implement the development protocol, and they are utilizing it for it. So used in infotainment issue. Infotainment issue means what? Infotainment means information. So whatever information you want, you will see in the car, that is called infotainment panel will be there on the front near driver. This is the most frame. You can see there are types of most frame, 25, 50, 150, depending on their frame size, then depending on the data, depending on the steam data channel, they have it. So it's just a smaller one, bigger one, and depending on number of bytes you can see. Okay, Ethernet. Most of you know the Ethernet. Now it's like a LAN cable, which we use for the connecting two laptops or many computers in a server. Similar way, we can connect the ECU. So this is in-vehicle network. Within a vehicle, when you want to transmit data within between two ECUs, you can use this Ethernet. And Ethernet is always client and server. Server is always the master's computer. Client is always the last computer where the data is getting or sending or whatever. So it's a client-centric event. In future, will replace most as well as CAN. So client-centric event means the ECU will trigger, like consider my laptop currently is a client and the server is internet. So I am getting information from the internet, whatever I want. So that's what communication using IP address, I can get those data. Mostly used in ADAS, autonomous vehicle and cybersecurity safety systems. ADAS, you know, ADAS systems like cruise control and all like radar, lidar, automotive, autonomous vehicle, you know, like Tesla's car. In those, they are using Ethernet because Ethernet is very high speed and very reliable protocol. Cybersecurity, we know, we generally nowadays, car also has cybersecurity because those also are connected now to internet. And just because they're connected to internet, they can be hacked. And when they can be hacked, we need to have a cybersecurity so that it will be hack-proof. So these are the advantages of Ethernet. And this is just Ethernet frame. There's a preamble block, destination MAC address. As you know, there's a MAC address of any PC, similar like client and server. Two ECUs, one have destination MAC address, one will have source MAC address, then type of the Ethernet type, payload and CRC. Payload is always data, CRC is calculated based on the data, and the Ethernet type 1 and type 2. Now, this is used for that frame type, and we know preamble is just, I think before sending an address, we need some data to send it. Okay, these are the total frame of the Ethernet. This is the overview. So whatever the types of protocol I told, within that you can see the speed, cable type, and application. So speed is very, very important factor in automotive industry, because if we don't want to send the data very high speed, then we will consider lean protocol. If our speed is requirement is medium, then we choose CAN. But if our requirement says I have to send the data very fastly, then I have to choose any one of them. So depending on my requirements, depending on the data to be transmission, we will choose those protocols. And these are the cable type which used for each one of them. And you can see the applications where they can use it. So this is overview. Now you learned about automotive protocol. You saw these are the types of protocols which we widely use in automotive industry. Then which is the most useful or which is used widely in automotive is a CAN protocol. CAN is used very often in every issue communication. So because it balances it. It's not too low speed also, it is not too high speed also, it is not too costly also, it is not too cheaper also. So it is like a golden zone of it. If you don't know what to choose, we can directly choose CAN first of all, and we can see CAN our requirements implemented using CAN. Next is Lean and CAN FD. Depending on which side you want to go, do you want to go with high speed or again low speed, you can choose that. Then after that, very specific for specific application, we use FlexRay most on Ethernet, which is very high-end issue. So high-end issue can be, these are steering, traction, media players, IP cameras, radar, infotainment. These are high-end issue where the data should be processed at very high speed. So this is the mostly used protocols. A job opportunities. So most of the times a CAN and Lean is a must in automotive industry. If you know the basic of it, then the company will choose that candidate over the another. And I think everyone should know at least basic of it. So that it will be helpful for them in interviews. There is another post. The driver, CAN driver developer. So what this engineer does, it implements, it configures a driver. So what is mean by driver? Driver means when you install some softwares, you need some drivers to plug in or plug out. When you plug in or plug out USB, the drivers of the USB will be installed automatically. Drivers means what? The interfaces to understand, to connect USB properly, to connect when you put DVDs inside that, you need to have DVD drivers for it. So those kind of drivers, similar like CAN, should have drivers. When you connect another issue to our issue, then you should understand, configure that driver, should have driver to communicate with that another issue. Network configurator. So which configures the network. We saw many networks like bus topology, star topology. So these are the bus networks. How you want to connect many SUVs within a network, this engineer will do network configuration. Then we have CAN Lean application development. So application development configures the message, configures the data. He verifies the data validity, and he will send the data. So these are the three engineers which requires to control the communication. So this is some example I have given here, automotive issues. These are YouTube videos. You can go and check some issues, how they works. These are the references I have attached where I have taken this slides information. You can go in deep and you can understand each and every protocol, what's their basic and advanced things. And thank you for listening to this training.